Hello, this is Päivi from Peony and Parakeet, and I'm sitting here in my studio with all the colored pencils, and I just can't wait to show you the video I've made about chaos and creativity. And the idea behind the chaos came when I thought about the quality of art. And for me, the quality of art consists of three factors. The first is the idea behind the artwork, how brilliant that is. The second are the technical skills, often overrated. And the third is the creativity. And when I thought about creativity, I realized that I'm thinking about some kind of chaotic state where I fully trust myself and let go. So I noticed that creativity and chaos are actually closely linked together. And next I'm going to show you how to add chaos and how it will improve your art. So let's get started. We all have created art where everything is under control. The elements are spread evenly. The composition has a lot of symmetry. And the colors have no or little variation. Actually, many say that their art journal pages are chaotic. Still, many of them are super controlled. You might have made a mess with your backgrounds, but if you only use a couple of tubes of color, spread everything evenly, and work slowly when drawing, I doubt that you have experimented chaos. It can really take your art to the next level. In this video, I will be creating an art journal page with a black pen and colored pencils. While I create the page, I will show you what I mean with embracing chaos. First, I just doodle freely on the white page. I work fairly fast. I let the lines cross over each other. I make really long and very short strokes. I doodle both edgy and round shapes. I use thinner and thicker pen to get some variation to the thickness. In this artwork, I experimented between chaos and control. First, I drew stiff ornaments and then imagined how they would look like if some chaos would be added to them. This art journal spread is colored with colored pencils, and even if it looks pretty controlled in color, there's a lot of variation in most colored areas. That little chaos makes the page look alive. Now back to the art journal page that I'm making. When I change to the colored pencils, I do not color the shapes, but use them as an inspiration. While coloring, I think about painting instead of drawing. That makes me much more creative for using the pencils than if I think about drawing. The chaos in coloring means that I mix the colors, use controversial colors, and add layers of colors. Thank you. I also include the chump. It means that I decide to fully trust my intuition and feelings for a brief moment. This art journal page was inspired by the night in opera. There, I heard the singer making the jump, a skillful one. I might be much clumsier and not able to climb so high, but I can still do it, fully embrace the chaos, let go of control, and just let my pens dance, like I'm flying in the air. Now I take the jump in the art journal page that I'm making. Here you will see how I just take the black pen without any idea and work really fast. It is like jumping over the cliff. Feels awful at first, but then so great. This is the chaos, but also the climax, where the actual idea of the page is set. This is an art journal page about the feeling after the jump. It is like leaving the stage, but still seeing the light of it. The flower bouquets are waiting in the back room. It's so easy to continue creating and adding details to the page. I already know what the theme of the page is. It is about growing together, improving our art, learning from every experience. I work with a small area at a time, trying to make it as beautiful as I can. In the end, I add the final touch of chaos by erasing small stripes where I add journaling. You can start adding chaos by doing something that comes to your mind, even if it does not make any sense in the first place. You can give yourself a time frame or an area from the page where you implement it. That way your chaos does not get too big and destructive. While creating, think positively about yourself and what you have created. If you feel confident, you will allow yourself to do crazy creative things. More information about positive self-criticism can be found at my blog. Have a creative day!